Do you know that over half of the women who menstruate experience cramps? I sometimes feel that it does not get enough recognition. People think it's normal to have period pain. No, it's not normal to be miserable because of excruciating period pain. It's not normal to miss work, miss school, or miss on normal everyday life activities. So I want you ladies to take action to help relieve menstrual pain. I've personally struggled with it. Over time, I have tried and learned different ways and new approaches that actually help relieve pain. So in this video, I'm gonna share my tips that will help you get rid of period cramps and get period pain relief. I'm your pharmacist, Sidra, and you're going to get the pharmacist recommended tips here at Ask Your Pharmacist. If you experience period pain, it's natural to wonder what causes menstrual cramps. The pain that you experience in your stomach, lower back, groin, or upper thighs. Now, menstrual cramps occur when your uterus contracts to shed the uterine lining and is most likely caused by an excess of prostaglandins. Prostaglandins are basically present in your uterus and are released when the uterine lining is shed, but if they're present in excess, they can cause pain. Also, during your period, the muscles of your womb are going to contract and relax to help shed the built-up lining. So sometimes you'll experience cramps, which are basically your muscles at work. So how to stop these menstrual cramps? So I recommend that you massage with essential oils, because massage actually may reduce the uterine spasms by relaxing the uterus. And in order to most effectively manage the period cramps, massage should focus on the abdominal area. But if you're able to get a full body massage, then why not? Because it's gonna reduce your overall stress and may help you relieve the menstrual cramps. Now, I personally rub essential oils in circular motions for just 5 minutes on the abdominal area, and that literally helps lessen the cramps. That also boosts the blood circulation in that area. And my favorite essential oil for cramps are peppermint and lavender, because the cooling effect from the peppermint is so refreshing and soothing. And the lavender actually is a natural muscle relaxant, which helps in releasing the tension associated with cramping. My second tip is to use a TENS therapy. TENS is basically a method of pain relief that uses these tiny electric currents to help relieve pain. And this is my personal favorite pain relieving technique because it's non-invasive and medication free. You just place these adhesive pads on or near the painful area. Then you turn on the TENS unit, and the soothing pulses from the TENS unit sent through the pads into your skin is actually going to help relieve the cramps. Just make sure you don't place your TENS pads on an open wound or rash, any swollen or infected area, any area which is inflamed. Also, do not apply it on your chest area, on your face, throat, or I would say not near heart. TENS units are easily available. You can buy it from any drugstore, or you can get it from Amazon for under $100. I actually got mine from Amazon. I'll put the link for you in the description. You can check that out. Third tip is to apply heat. Next time when you find yourself curling up because of the menstrual pain, then maybe try using any heating pad or any heating blanket. Or if none of that is available, just use a hot water bottle, whatever you have. Basically, you just want to apply heat on the painful area because heat can help relax your muscles. It can also improve the blood flow and relieve tension. Applying heat is a tried and true method, and it's been working for ages. It's really like a cheap method to help relieve the pain with no side effects. Research actually has shown that heat is as effective as using an over-the-counter NSAID like Motrin, which is pretty amazing. Some women say that they don't have time to apply heat because they can't just sit in one corner and relax or chill out. Well, guess what? If you're at work or school or just are on the go, then you can buy the reusable chemical heating packs. And this is something that you can carry in your purse anywhere you go. You just snap the internal disc to activate the heat, and to reuse them, you just have to boil them in water. These heating packs are really portable, compact, and great if you're traveling or just out and about. My fourth tip is to drink herbal tea. Drinking actually chamomile, fennel, or ginger tea is an easy, natural way to relieve menstrual cramps. I actually like to add a tablespoon or a teaspoon of fennel seeds in a cup full of water, let it boil, and then add my lemon ginger or any turmeric green tea bag, let it seep through. And this tea is not only great in taste, but it actually helps relieve menstrual cramps. It's great for your digestion as well. In fact, ginger and turmeric have anti-inflammatory properties, and fennel seeds help regulate your hormones, improve digestion, and reduce inflammation. I actually start drinking this tea 3 days before my periods, and it really helps prevent the period cramps. My next tip is to exercise. Now, if you have period pain, exercise might be the last thing on your mind, but trust me, gentle exercise and some yoga poses really help ease out the menstrual pain. And right now you may be thinking that I'm crazy, that I'm recommending exercise while in period pain. I know it sounds cliche, but exercise actually releases the endorphins that actually are associated with making you feel happy, reduce pain, and relax your muscles. Now, I'm not saying to go to the gym and do your jumping jacks or kickboxing. Just do gentle exercise. Maybe a 15-minute walk or light yoga, stretching, or just a bit of a weight training. Whatever actually feels good, whatever helps to stretch those abdominal muscles to relieve the pain. You could do any yoga poses that would help stretch your abdomen, or any muscle that feel tensions that can just literally do the trick. And my go-to stretch is actually the child's yoga pose and inverted leg pose. These poses are actually great to support your reproductive and digestive system. They help reduce anxiety, fatigue, headache, and menstrual cramps. And they can actually also help with the depression. Taking supplements is very important. Sometimes taking vitamins and supplements really help with the period cramps. An important vitamin that you want to consider is vitamin D and calcium, because they actually help reduce inflammation. And some other supplements could be our omega-3, vitamin B, and magnesium, because they also help reduce the inflammation and they can actually make your period less painful. Because during your periods, your abdominal area or sometimes the uterus gets swollen, and that's part of the reason why you're getting cramps. And if you're using supplements and vitamins or even foods that help reduce that inflammation, it's going to make a lot of difference. Sometimes we are deficient of some vitamins and nutrients, so you can always get your blood work done and see if you are deficient in any supplements. If you don't have time to go to the doctor's office and give blood, you can always order like an in-home testing kit. Everly Well actually has these testing kits that you can order online, and they will send the kit at home. It's about like $50 to $60. You just collect the samples and then you just mail it to the lab, and they can actually check your vitamin deficiencies. And if you are deficient, then just take your supplements. But just remember, for best result, take your supplements every day, not just during your period. And because some supplements interact with your medications, be sure to check with your pharmacist or doctor before taking anything new. Tip number 7 is medications. Now, like I said in the beginning, that menstrual cramps can be due to too much prostaglandins, and taking over-the-counter medications like NSAIDs reduces the levels of prostaglandins in the body. NSAIDs like Motrin, Aleve, ibuprofen, they actually not only reduces the prostaglandin levels, but also reduce the pain and inflammation. But I recommend using any non-drug therapy first. Like I've mentioned before, try using vitamins, heat, exercise, and if all of that doesn't work, then use your medication, then use your over-the-counter medications as a backup. Sometimes the hormonal imbalance can also result in menstrual cramps. Then in that case, you can actually try the birth control pills, because leveling your estrogen and progesterone hormones help thin the uterine lining, so it sheds the lining more easily. Hormonal birth controls also regulate the length and frequency of your periods, and some forms of birth control can actually completely alleviate your period cramps by stopping your period altogether. And that's only when your periods are extremely painful, then it might help just using a continuous pack of birth control or a continuous method of birth control, which would alleviate your periods and give you some relief. It is a little tricky to use birth controls because you have to take the pill same time every day. There are active pills and then inactive pills. Some women kind of get confused with that. So do talk to your pharmacist on how to use them. There are some interactions with the birth control pills as well. So if you are taking any antibiotics or any other medications, do check with your pharmacist just so you have full understanding of the birth control pills. Also, I have a video on the birth control pills. If you would like more detail on it, you can just check that out. I'll put the link in the description. Also, I'll put the link in the I button for you. So do check that out. It's pretty helpful. Sometimes you get the period cramps because of underlying conditions like endometriosis or PCOS. Like I personally have endometriosis, due to which I used to get extremely painful periods. I actually also had the PCOS, due to which I had to get surgery. And after surgery, as a prevention, my doctor recommended to put me on Depo Provera shot. This is like a shot that we inject every 3 months. And when you use it for long term, it actually alleviates your periods. So because of using that, I am actually completely pain free. Well, knock on the wood, hopefully it doesn't come back. Depo shot is actually great in alleviating the period pain, and it also helps with the excess bleeding. Depo shot actually also reduces the risk of endometrial cancer. But like I said, do check with your doctor. It's not for everybody. It worked for me. It may work for you or may not work for you. So always check with your doctor to weigh your benefits versus risks. Also, one thing to keep in mind is that you don't want to use the Depo shot for more than 2 years because it actually decreases the bone density. Now, if you have tried everything and your pain is still unmanageable and you have painful periods to an extent that it's affecting your everyday activity, then talk to your primary care doctor or OBGYN so you can get proper diagnosis and find the underlying cause of the pain. You can actually discuss with your doctor about the birth control options or other forms of treatment, because a little help from the doctor might be the best way to stop the dreadful period pain. Well, I hope you found this video helpful. Please share it with someone who actually suffers from the period pain and would benefit from it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments or DM me. And if you haven't already, subscribe now so you don't miss any informative video on health and pharmacy. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.